This is most likely gonna be the most controversial video I've ever made in this game. But it doesn't have to be though. Don't you just hate it when your parents text you and they call everything you do streaming? Like, I don't stream every single day, mom. I don't! Peachy. What's going on, guys? I'm here. Welcome back to a brand new video on the channel. Welcome back to Mario Kart Wii, of course. It's Custom Track Grand Prix, playing online again. Custom Track this time around. Found a pretty good lobby. At least I think it's pretty good. And with good, I always mean enough people to actually race with, okay? I'm not talking about skill here because I'm still around 6k VR. It's not going anywhere, to be honest. Ooh, little slip drift. I think that's slip drift, right? I barely know the terminology in this game. As you probably already read the title, this video is gonna be... Well, okay, let me just put it this way. You gotta hear me out in order for this video to work, okay? Don't jump to conclusions right away. Let's go, you got blued. That works. I do think I have a pretty good argument, a few actually, to make this title work out. And it's a discussion video, right? I'm not trying to prove you any points here. I'm not trying to, like, you know, blame anyone here either. So can there be too many custom tracks? And first of all, I'm talking about Custom Track Grand Prix, okay? There really can't be too many custom tracks just in general, because the more custom tracks people make, the better. I will agree on that, that's for sure, but on the Custom Track Grand Prix, right? I think that most people that play custom tracks online play with Custom Track Grand Prix. And I know there's some other services out there as well, but most people, when they're playing custom tracks on Mario Kart Wii Online, use Custom Track Grand Prix. I know there's a new method where you can just play without having Custom Track Grand Prix, but that's regular tracks, though. What's that red, dude? Oh my god, that red chased me all the way. Huh. I took a very tight line there, though. How did that red, like, come up in front? Oh my god, target shocked as well. This is the reason I'm not higher than 6k VR, guys. This is the reason. Hopefully the guy first gets blued again. It's a far shot, though. It's a long shot. But I hope for it. So where I'm talking about is just the tracks in Custom Track Grand Prix. I think there are around 200 tracks on this, maybe a bit more. And there's some very good tracks out there. I think this track right there is very good. There's some very memorable tracks as well. Mushroom Peak is one of those. It's not necessarily good gameplay wise, at least in my opinion. But it's one of the oldest tracks in the pack, so it's respectable. Whoa. That loop was really weird, I'm not sure. But I think everyone can agree that some of the tracks in the spec are better than some of the other tracks. And it's cool that there are like so many tracks out there, it's dope. But wouldn't it be better if they just remove those bad tracks so you always play on better tracks overall? Like, it might sound weird, right? Why would you, like, why is less more? Oh my god. Oh, I deserve to lose at this point, man. We had a good chance getting second, but I just choked that. No startup as well, getting fifth. Oh my god, that was just so bad. How did I hit that wall right there? But wouldn't less be more if they just removed the worst tracks? And I guess tracks are like subjective based, right? You might like a track, I don't. And that's the hard part about this all. But I'm very much aware that it's like impossible to please everyone on Custom Track Grand Prix or just with anything in life. Like, I know Mr. Bean gets a lot of shit and Shatters as well. You know, if they remove a custom track, because it's someone's favorite, right? Someone playing this game. You know, for example, if they remove this track for any reason whatsoever, they're gonna get shit. Okay, we good. And of course, removing this track was just an example. I'm pretty sure it's like a new track. The edit is not too long ago, so I don't see this track going anywhere soon. But you know what I mean, right? They get a lot of shit for just, you know, updating the game. Like, no matter what they do, they always have someone that's complaining. So, respect to those guys for sure. And respect everyone making the tracks as well, because I know it's not easy, right? It takes a lot of time. It must take a lot of time. I don't make tracks myself, but I make textures, and those alone take time. And I'm not gonna try to call some bad tracks out there in this video. That's not what this video is for, right? This video is not to like prove a point, it's just to have a discussion about the amount of tracks and what, like, it's the hardest part is that the track quality is going up, like, you know, as time goes on. I should have made that. I think it's 100cc, it must be. I'm not sure. Can you make this? Oh, I shouldn't have tried. Okay, that's fine. I was about to say, I don't think you can make it when you're small on 100. It might be 150. I should check the speedometer, but I don't know. I'm stuttering right now as well. That's horrible. Okay. But this video is not to, like, blame anyone or to just shit on Custom Track Grand Prix. I think it's, like, the best service out there, you know. I have just so much respect for everyone in the community. But the hardest part is, and this is what I think, is that the custom tracks over the years got better quality-wise. But then some of the tracks are, like, memorable. So people don't want to, like, you know, have them removed. It's stuff like that that makes it so hard, but it's good as well, though, you know, the fact that custom tracks are still getting improved and, you know, the layouts are getting better and better and stuff like that. And there's still tracks out from, like, 2013 that still keep up, and that's also dope, you know. It's just hard to make this video, I guess. I'm not sure. Probably should have made this video. Because I already know I'm gonna get hate for this, right, no matter what, because there's always people just disagreeing, which I guess makes sense. Oh, third place, there you go, he choked at the end right there, you know, the Baby Peach using... I'm not even sure what that card is called, but it's a card that says enough. But I'm aware I'll always get shit for making this video, so, but that's fine, it's not about me here. Like, what's the perfect track amount? I guess there's no perfect amount. Like, I'm pretty sure every single one person that plays this game, you know, Custom Tracks, can, like, at least give, like, 5 tracks in the pack that they don't enjoy. But the problem is, every single one's list is gonna be different than the next person, so you can't just remove the 5 tracks, because then you end up removing every track in the game, because there's always someone, again, having different opinions, which... That's, again, not a bad thing, but it's hard. All I'm trying to say here, and this is just my opinion, is that I think it would be better if they just remove some tracks, and I'm not sure which tracks, but... There must be a few tracks that everyone thinks are, like, stupid, right? There's, like, this one track that's literally just a circle. I'm not sure what it's called, and I'm not gonna call it out, but I'm pretty sure you know which track I'm talking about. It almost never gets picked, because people don't like it too much. And the more quality tracks you have in your pack, the more quality the average rate is gonna be. And, like, the casual players, or not even casual, but just players that pick random, have a better chance of picking an actual good track while picking random. And... I'm not quite sure what's a good track though, because, you know, it has a different definition for some people. Like, some people like good graphics, good layouts, you know, or maybe an easy layout for, like, you know, less experienced players, maybe luck tracks. Everyone has, like, different opinions, which... Oh my god, I think the pack is very solid right now, you know, all the tracks combined. I think it's an okay pack. You can definitely see that they actually picked the best tracks out there right now. And there's still some tracks out there that aren't in the pack yet, but hopefully I'll get it soon. Make sure you leave your opinion on this down in the comments though. I'm not sure where this video is gonna go, but I don't know. I just felt like I wanted to talk about this because I don't really feel like anyone talks about this on YouTube here. Not that too many people actually upload this game, but... You know, I think it's interesting to talk about topics like this, and I like doing it as well. Even though, again, it might be controversial every once in a while, but I think it's, like, important as well, though. Even though sometimes the videos don't go anywhere, I think it's just interesting to talk about nonetheless. Yo, Kitty Cat keeping it up, though. Look at that. What's that card called, though, you know? How is he in first? By the way, shoutouts to Meowser. I've been talking about this, and been showing him off in the last few... You know, times that I've been playing this game on the channel, but Meowser will be releasing very, very soon the Bowser texture for every single card and bike in the game, so that's gonna be sick. I'm almost done with the actual Bowser texture, and I've been working on the Bowser bike, and then I gotta do all the other, you know, vehicles, which will take less time than actually doing the whole Bowser, because I think that's the most important thing. It's gonna be finished soon, though, don't worry. Again, I just wouldn't mind having, like, a few custom tracks removed, right? Even if they remove, like, 20, you know, the average race will probably go up, right? The quality of the races, and... You know, less might be more in this scenario right there, but then again, having more custom tracks is always fun as well, for like time trials especially. It's just hard, okay? That's what it mostly comes down to. It's impossible to create a perfect, you know, pack, at least I think so. Yeah, this room is not too good, but that's actually quite good for me though, because, you know, the best thing how you can improve on this game, at least I think so, is by just playing it, of course. But if you play against people with like the high-end VR, which are way better than me, they know all the strats and stuff like that, it's hard to improve because you're always sticking in the back, right? You can't really break away because you get destroyed on every single turn. So I think it's good to like play against people from your skill level and maybe just a little bit above your skill level so you can see what they're doing, but still keep up and get that experience that you need. I think that's the most important thing. I picked Rush City Run on like random. I like that though. Rush City Run is one of my favorites, but I've got like 20 favorites, and that's the thing as well though. There's so many good tracks in the spec. And so little bad ones, but it's just hard. N64 Toad's Turnpike, that might be another, like, thing right there. Maybe some people don't like to have retros in the spec, which I'm not sure who that is. But it's possible, right? Maybe they only want actual custom tracks. Not that these aren't custom tracks, but, like, actual tracks made by other people. I don't know, it's just stuff like that where I think it's always fun to think about, even though I never get anywhere and it's... Most just gonna give me shit at the end, but I like Toad's Turnpike though, to be honest. I think this one is the better version. The one in the Marguerite Deluxe, like, kinda meh. Then again, I do still like that one because it's the only dark track in the actual game, I believe. So, that's always a good thing. But yeah, the strat in this track is just to stick to, like, the corners, even though I'm, like, struggling right now. Oh, I'm dead. It's definitely a front-running track though. Definitely. But I do have a few questions for you guys though. Do you guys want any tracks to be removed, right? Do you want to have less tracks in the actual pack? Or do you just want to have, like, tracks replaced by other tracks or whatever? And what are your favorite tracks in the game? And then what are your least favorite tracks? You know, just to have, like, a little discussion, a little... Oh my god, he sniped a bomb. Ah, I'm dead, dude. I'm second place, though. We're keeping up, I guess, but... It's not going well. Yo, Kitty Cat, though, has been, like, doing so much work. using little baby Peach in the card. I feel so bad losing to him though. Or to her, I'm not sure. I don't want to assume any genders here. Also, this is actually the first time I called out I was going to like record. Oh my god, dude. He backspammed that red. Why? I mean, it makes sense because if he threw it forward, it would probably just break on the car. Oh my god, getting out of bounds in this track. That doesn't. It's not good, okay? What's that respawn, huh? Either way, this is the first video I actually do while I called it out on Discord, and the thing kind of is, I don't think anyone on Discord plays this game online, at least custom tracks. I know there are a few people in my Discord that play this, like, again, as I said earlier, without the custom tracks, just, you know, using regular Reunify or Mario Kart Wii, which is also dope that it can work. Again, don't really take anything that I say about the pack too hard, because again, everyone has different opinions on this, which is why it's hard for Mr. Bean and Chatters. I don't know, man, I feel like I keep repeating myself here, but I don't want to, like, hurt anyone either, right? I do want to, like, talk about it, but it's, like, it's very controversial, and I don't want to, like, you know, participate in any controversial BS. I want to be real with you guys, though. I think that's the main thing here. I want to be real with you guys and, you know, talk about what I think and talk about what, you know, I like and what I don't. I think someone's messing with my door, by the way. I keep hearing it going. I was in the freaking room right there, dude. What? Oh my god, they were just chasing me, dude. This little stretch right here, a little, you know, this route's like the scariest, but it's the fastest though, so it's always worth it, but meh. I'm making some close calls here, but I'm keeping up, you know, getting lucky here and there. I'll take that though. Alright, second place, let's see if I can do this. I feel like I always get lost on this track. I'm not quite sure why. There you go. Thank you very much. Oh, triple res and first is actually quite nice. Hopefully they die when I hit this. No! They actually don't die hitting red shells. That sucks. Okay, we're still first. Yeah, you see this texture? It's really hard because you can see the texture on the background kind of blends in. That's like the thing. I'm not sure I could actually fix that, but it's just a little thing to keep in mind. It's very hard to know where you gotta jump or to release your mini turbo or anything like that. Oh, that's disgusting! You saw the fifth, dude. How can you avoid that? I'm not gonna question it, though. Let's go, man. First place. Or I'm second, actually. I'll take second, though. I thought I was first. And I was about to say, getting a Mega Mushroom in second would have been disgusting, but no. There you go. I do think that's gonna do for this video, though. I don't wanna make this video too long here. I do think I said what I wanted to say. If you guys enjoyed, please make sure you leave a like down below, you know. I hope you guys, you know, agree to me to some degree. If not, then that's okay as well. Of course, everyone has different opinions on this, which is why I feel like it's important to talk about. Huge, huge shoutouts to, again, Mr. Bean and Shatters and everyone that makes custom tracks. And also, you know, the Weemfy, you know, Weem. Shoutouts to him as well. Shoutouts to everyone in the community, guys. I love all of you. And, yeah, I hope this wasn't too controversial. It wasn't supposed to be this kind of thing. I really don't want to be involved in any controversial BS, so I hope you guys still enjoyed, and yeah, I hope it wasn't too controversial. I hope I don't get too many dislikes on this. It's probably unavoidable though, but thank you guys so much for watching, and I'll see you guys in the next video. Enjoy your stay.